Good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning. I want to thank you guys for tuning in. Of course, I am live on Sadora Radio, the station that is more than just music. I am your host, Angela Thomas Smith, Walk in Purpose with Angela. I'm waiting for my guests to come into the backstage so that we can go live on the radio. But I am currently live on the radio this morning. I'm going to be doing some things a little different. I'm excited to announce that I will now be live every Sunday morning right here on Sadora Radio from 8 a.m. to 10 a.m. I will be making my announcement today live on the air. So if you would please share this broadcast with your circle of influence. If you would start a watch party, whatever you would like to do to share this for me and my guests. I have two amazing guests that are gonna grace my platform during this 8 o'clock hour. I'm super excited to be sharing their journey to walking in purpose as authors, and excited to find out what exactly they are doing in their lives and how they're impacting this world. So we're gonna enjoy this music just a little while and wait for my other guests to show up, and then we're gonna be going live over the radio. I'm gonna allow y'all to enjoy this music with Sadora Radio right now. And if y'all have questions for my guests, make sure that you are posting them in the comment section. Or if you have questions for me, make sure you post them in the comment section, and we will get these questions answered over the air and over the broadcast. But I'm waiting for one of my guests to show up, and then we're going to be going live. Good morning, good morning, good morning. You are tuned in to Walk in Purpose with Angela on Sadora Radio, the station that is more than just music. I want to thank you guys for tuning in. Okay, my other guest is arriving. I see him coming in the backstage. So now I have both guests backstage. So I'm gonna let this song play. And when this song play, I'm going to allow my guests to come up. I see one of my guests is having problems connecting. But I'm going to bring them up so I can get them situated. Okay, Core has to need to connect to your mic in your headset. Is that you posting in the private chat? Oh no, that was Corey. He said he has to go get his laptop because something's going on with his phone. But I'm about to get ready to go live. If you are listening, I mean, if you are tuned in, if you are watching me on Facebook, I need you to let me know if you can hear me. So you can't hear no music playing? I'm having some technical difficulties that I have to get worked out. So if you are tuned in to Sadora Radio, I need for you to let me know if you can hear me live on Sadora Radio. I need for you to let me know if you can hear make my announcement. I'm getting ready to make an announcement, and I need you to let me know if you can hear the announcement. Good morning, good morning, good morning. I want to thank you for tuning in to Walk and Purpose with Angela. I am Angela Thomas Smith, the host of Walk and Purpose. You are tuned in to Sadora Radio, the station that is more than just music. Could y'all hear that?
Yeah.
So did you hear me make my announcement?
Yeah.
Did you hear the announcement?
Yeah, we heard it. Well, I heard it.
What did I say?
You say... you say...
you hearing it because you on live, but they're not hearing it on the radio. So oh, I've got to...
Okay.
I'm not going to be able to use this headset again. That's why I was trying to test over the weekend, but it's not working. So I'm going to have to use my other headset. I have to go back. It's not, I'm supposed to be over the music. That's supposed to let me be over the music. And it's not letting, it's not. Because when I unhooked from my headset from the Western, it came. Okay, I should be fine. It's not fine, huh? I'm gonna have to figure this out. I mean, I'm gonna have to go live. I gotta figure this out. I gotta figure out why my headset is not connected to my what's the name and how. It only works with this. I only got one headset. It don't pick up. Is it right? It's just me. I'm having technical difficulties, y'all, but just hold on. I'm trying to get my stuff back up and running, y'all. It happens sometimes, but I have to keep pressing. Now what just happened? Oh, Lord. I beat that devil right now in the name of Jesus. Huh. It is. I don't know what is going on with my system. It's been playing fine this morning. Now I just want to act up. I was doing just fine. Having no issues. It's not fun. Okay, I see Corey is on. Join the crowd. We having technical issues this morning. I see you was having technical issues. Now I'm having technical issues.
Yeah, my phone wasn't working.
But it's all good. We gonna press through in just a second. I'm about to figure out what's going on. About to get my... See if I can get my station manager on the line. Because I don't know what's going on. It ain't even playing my music. Okay, there you go. It's playing the music now. It's a delay. It should be playing now. Yeah, it's a delay. it's a delay. That there was a lie. And the truth ain't in them today. We good, y'all. I got this. I want to see y'all a little different. Okay. And some need to sit down before we go live on air. Good morning, good morning, good morning. I want to thank you guys for tuning in to Walk and Purpose with Angela. I am Angela Thomas Smith, the host of Walk and Purpose.
Hey, how you doing today?
Hey, everybody.
So today I am super excited about my guest that I have on today. So, I'm gonna bring them up. So please let me know if you are tuned in over the broadcast. I want to you to let me know if you can hear me, because we are having some technical issues, and I'm not sure if I am being live over the broadcast. So if you guys are listening to me on Sador Radio, let me know if you can hear me. So I am definitely having some technical issues over on my broadcast system. So I need to really find out what's going on, because I am not live. It's playing the music, but it's not allowing me to it's not allowing me to talk. I'm not understanding that. So can y'all hear me?
Yes,
we can hear you.
Okay, I got it. Thank you. So we are live on Sador Radio. I am Angela Thomas Smith. We have been having some technical issues over on Sador Radio, but of course I am live on Facebook as well. So my audience here on Facebook can hear me, but those over on Sador Radio cannot. But I'm glad that we have that worked out, and I have you guys here with me, and I'm excited to bring up my guests and allow them to share just a little bit about who they are. First, I'm going to be allowing Ashley to share just a little bit about who she is. If you have something on, could you pause it for it, please? Can you turn that off in the background?
I'll turn it out. Okay.
Thank you.
Hey, how y'all doing? I'm from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. And I'm an author, and what else I could say? That's all I can say. I'm from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. I'm an author, and I got some more things coming.
So how long have you been writing?
I've been writing since seventh grade.
All right. So, Corey, good morning.
Good morning.
And welcome. I tell you, it was a journey trying to get on here this morning. It seemed like we was having problems. But I thank you for pressing your way. And I thank those that are tuned in for staying connected and not giving up on us. So, Corey,
yes.
Tell me just a little bit about who you are.
Well, my name is Corey Sarver, Louisville, single fathers, entrepreneur, Nine Books Road, fast, I sell earrings, shirts, and masks.
Wow. I see you on Facebook. Because everybody that know me know I'm a Facebooker, and I love Facebook. And that's how I network. And for those that don't know who I am and don't follow me, I am the founder of AALAC, which is the African American Author Literacy Awareness Campaign. I'm also the CEO of Aspiring Authors Magazine. And my desire is to bring awareness to brown authors all over this world and touch on topics that's affecting our brown community. So in doing that, I am very out there on Facebook trying to connect with my brown people and trying to let them know that they have purpose and that there's a reason why they're here. And I see you. I see you. I see you everywhere. Everywhere I go, I see you. And I'm glad that you are in my circle. So I want you to share just a little bit about why you got into writing and why is this your journey and how did this become your purpose?
Well, with me, though, I got a hell of a story. You know, you can take it all the way back to back in the day, though, with me. I always liked writing poetry when I was 13, 14 years old. But my transition, though, was once I got in my 20s, I got my daughter. I started writing more, and then so I put my story out there, let people know the transition from the streets to single father. You know, I upgraded my book, so to doing the affirmation books, the children's books now, to where the passion is more different than it was not writing my story out. Now I'm actually trying to help people with my writing with the affirmation book I just dropped, then my daughter's children's book, though. So I'm trying to make it more you know, awareness with the writing, you know, making more of an impact on people. Or you just tell them, I went from the streets to a single father.
Wow. You are definitely setting an example for a lot of our brown males. I'm going to jump over here and talk to Ashley real quick, but I definitely want to come back to you because I want to touch on some things that's going on right now that we need to talk about. And that's one thing I pride myself on is touching on things that's affecting our brown community. So you hold tight. Ashley B. Writing.
Yes.
That's what you go by.
Yeah.
So tell me what you be writing.
Well, Ashley B. Writing come from a lady in Atlanta. When I was up there with music, actually, and I was up there selling my books on the street of Atlanta, and I ended up meeting her, and she named me Ashley B. Writing. So we talked about her being my manager and stuff like that, so we're going to see how that go. And I'll be writing everything from poetry to spoken word to drama to spiritual, you know. I write everything to sitcoms, to short stories. Oh, no.
So what got you into writing?
Well, what got me into writing always was the type of person that I love entertainment. So I just one day had picked up a book because I went to private school. So I just picked up a book. And I just say, oh, you know what? I bet y'all can write. So I just started writing. And from middle school, I just always wrote, always been in, you know, poetry contests in school. And so that just kept me to keep on writing. And I say, I bet I could do a novel. So I end up doing a novel. So I got four books all together. And I'm working on another one that's coming out in January.
Wow. So, well, I'm going to talk about me really quick. I do that sometimes. So y'all know I got 18 books, right? So writing was never something that I wanted to do. Never in a million years I thought I would be writing a book. And doing this, what I'm doing now, no, never. But did y'all see yourselves doing exactly what you're doing? Or was it your life journey that got you here? Corey.
I know I never seen myself writing though. I know it was not in my books or my life, it was not part of me though. I knew I ain't think I would be here though, you know, honestly. I ain't think I would make it to, you know, somewhere I'm at my age anyway though. So writing was not a something in my life though. My testimony is my writing there. Cause I wouldn't think I would make it 35 years old. You know, so I should have been dead anyway. So my thing is writing came to me after my transition to life. And it came in passion, though. Tell people the story. Because, you know, honestly, writing was not a idea. I was a dope boy. You know, to sell drugs, though. Other than being pinched, you're dead anyway. So my daughter would change my life, though. So honestly, you know, now, yes, that's my future. I'm embracing with my daughter, though, you know, and now I'm changing, you know, where I'm at in life now. But honestly, no, I would never see myself being where I'm at right now, right? But thank God I'm where I'm at doing it, though. Telling my testimony, though, most definitely.
Wow. I want to stay right there just for a second because there are some males out there, you know, all that's taking place in this world. I look at a lot of our males, a lot of them are incarcerated. A lot of them are selling drugs. A lot of them are gang banging. And I just, you are an example for our young kids on how to be a father, how to be a role model, how to dream and chase your dream, because that's what you're doing. And I applaud you for that. You know, a lot of time, a lot of women bash the men for not being good fathers and not stepping up to the plate. But I applaud you and I applaud my nephew because you guys are definitely setting the standard for today's male and what they should be striving for. You know, I know you may not be where you want to be, but you're definitely in my book. You're up there and you're doing great. I thank you for that. I want to hear about your baby's book and why you chose to do the children's book.
I chose children's book. It was my daddy. I want to write a book about my life, though, about you raising me. I want people to know that you've been raising me, though. So I'm going to write my own book. And put my story out there, I'm letting people know that my daddy raised me until 3 years old. And we wrote the book, got the illustrations done, and we dropped the book what, 2 months ago. Now she's working on another children's book now called Joy and Stuff Animal Can Bring. And she's basically chasing my past, though, and just looking at what they done for her and giving her the opportunity to do it herself, though. You know what?
That's amazing. That's amazing. So, Ashley, where do you see yourself in 5 years on this writing journey?
Okay. I see myself being a big-time author. I see myself doing a lot of books, being on a lot of commercials, you know, a lot of radio shows, you know, traveling. Yeah. Working for myself. Yeah. So that's where I see myself.
And what's your message for those that are tuned in? Because I know with me, all these books that I do, my message is purpose. I want people to know that they can have purpose. I want them to know that they're not just placed here. That, you know, God had a reason for you. And you need to discover it. So that those things that you desire in your heart can manifest in your life. So I teach on purpose and I share my journey to help people walk in their purpose, discover their purpose. So what do you want people to walk away from your platform with?
I want people to understand to put God first. And to trust him and that you could do all things through Christ that strengthens you. You know, and long as you put him first, then you could do it.
Amen. Amen. Corey. So yeah, if y'all, I know y'all follow me on Facebook. So y'all know I've been asking the question, life, for the last couple of months. But now I've moved to another question. Another word. God been dealing with me with words. And he, you know how he broke that word life down? Well, he done broke some more words down. He done did about 12 of them. But I want y'all to tell me what that word power means to you guys. P-O-W-E-R. I want to start with Ashley. I want Corey to think about that. Because he look like he in deep thought.
Power.
Why y'all thinking? Why both of y'all thinking? I'm going to play this song really quick, okay? And then I'm going to come back, and I'm going to tell y'all what was downloaded in my spirit.
Okay. Thank you.
Welcome, welcome back. You are tuned in to Sedora Radio. I am Angela Thomas Smith. I am the host of Walk and Purpose. And we are the station that is more than just music. And I want to thank you guys for tuning in this morning. I have Ashley B. Writing and Corey Palmer with me. So we were talking about the word power before we went on break. And I was asking you guys what that word means. I want to share with you guys what was downloaded in my spirit. So the P stands for position. Position to overcome by being a willing vessel to empower others through your resilience. Do you get it? Wow. So what does that word mean to you, Corey?
Well, it can mean two ways coming from my background. You know it, right? And the power, you know, power back in the day used to mean that control. I heard that dominance in the streets. So you had the power, you know. Now the power to me is God, though, what God can do for you and do for others, I heard. And the power to change, the power to fight, the power to conquer, though. So when I look at power now, I look at it from a positive aspect versus using it as a negative in the street. So I would use power before as a negative. Don't try to control somebody's block, try to control somebody's neighborhood, you know, as a power thing. Now it's control as a power from God to willing to help people, though, willing to show people, though, what your power, what you're doing right, can do for other people, though. So that's my version of what power means on both sides of it.
Wow. Powerful. Ashley, what does that word mean to you?
The word means to me success. It means strength. It means faith. You know, when you could do what you want, go where you want, and say what you want, you have the power, you know. So that's overall, that's what it means to me.
Like, literally, when he gave me that word and he broke it down to me like that, I was talking to a young lady on Facebook and I was responding to her post, not knowing that this young lady was going through something. But immediately when he dropped this word in my spirit, we have to position ourselves. We have to put ourselves in a position to where we can overcome. That means we have to empower ourselves. Corey, I listened to you share about how you used to be in the streets and how you used to sell drugs. You overcame that because you empowered yourself. You put yourself in a position to be an overcomer because you wanted better for your baby. And then you was willing. You was a willing vessel. You said you weren't going to give up. You said you was going to empower yourself. And that's what you did. You started writing. You started sharing your story. You published your books. Not only did you publish your book, you helped your baby publish her book. You're creating legacy to empower others that's going to come after you. And then you're an example of resilience because you didn't give up. Everything that came at you, you kept pressing. You did not give up. So you are an example of power. So when somebody asks, what's the definition of power? You can show them a picture of yourself and tell them your story. Because, you know, God dropped something in my spirit a couple of weeks ago. We've been so consumed about the world and what the world perceive us. See, these words been defined in the definition, in the dictionary by Webster, accordingly. So he told us what that word means. And we accepted it. We accepted it. Because society said that's what we're supposed to accept. But God told me that was the meaning of the word power. Position to overcome by being a willing vessel to empower others through your resilience. And that's what you're doing. Now, is that not power?
Most definitely.
Y'all are amazing. I thank God for you guys. I thank him for your journey. I want you to share, Ashley, how those that are tuned in, those that are here on Facebook, and those that are listening on Sidora Radio, how can they follow you guys? Ashley, how can they get in contact with you? How can they purchase your book? What you have coming up? Come on, share really quick.
Well, you can get in contact with me on Instagram, AO the Artist 406, and Facebook is Ashley Hudson. And you can get my book, my email, AshleyHudson1677@gmail.com.
Amen, amen.
And what I got coming up, I got in January. I got this book in January that's called Hood Chronicles.
Hood Chronicles. Ooh, what's the overview of that?
Yeah, Hood Chronicles.
The overview of that?
It just talks about how we are raised up and how we think as coming up in the hood. And you know the things that we go through in different aspects.
Okay. You know, I like to share with people because sometimes people will read your title or hear your title and it'll turn them off. Because I'm almost
right.
This girl, the Gia, author Gia, she has that book, Hoes in the Hood, but it has an amazing message.
Right.
And if people can't get past the title of the book,
right,
they won't pick the book up and receive right. the message. And that's what I'm trying. That's one of the reasons why I have this platform is because I want to be able to bridge that gap between authors and readers, because some people, they look at your cover and they get turned off and won't right. even give the book a chance. But we trying to break those barriers. But I want to touch on some of the right now topics. Corey, I've had the privilege of having you on another one of my platforms. And we were talking about Black Lives Matter situation. Yeah, I think, matter of fact, the day you were on the show, I think we had just got the verdict for the Breonna Taylor case. And you are from Kentucky. So, you know, I definitely wanted to touch back up on that topic because you were touching on some great things over on the other network, and I want to finish that conversation. You know me, I like to finish some conversations. So we were talking about, so what has the state of Kentucky been like since all this has taken place?
You know, we're still protesting right now. We still out here on the block, still protesting right now. So, you know, it happened in my city, happening in Louisville, though. And, you know, we still out here 170 days protesting right now because Manolito still, he got charged, but then came up with a sex charge against him, though. We still trying to fight the case and trying to get rid of Daniel Cameron, though. That's what he threw out in the courts, though, for the Breonna Taylor case. He's still going down here in my city. We ain't stopping, though. We still protesting, still fighting for it. You know, that's one thing that where Kentucky is a red state, though, Republican state, though, Commonwealth, though, so it's been the same, though, since slave days, though. So ain't nothing changed by Kentucky, though.
Well, we as people, brown people, we got to come together ourselves. And we got to get us together. We got to start with us first because we can't get our communities in order because we got too much stuff going on with us.
Right.
And if we deal with us, then we can help empower, educate, and encourage those around us. Because when you heal and you're not dealing with all this, but see, what has happened is they done brushed everything up under the rug and they want us to think, they want us to be okay with everything. You know, they don't told us that we supposed to be strong and we supposed to do this and we supposed to do that and we supposed to let everything go. But we've turned the left cheek, the right cheek, the butt cheek, whatever. We ain't got no more cheeks to turn. So now it's time for us to take a stand. And we have to fight back. And we have to do what we got to do. And that means we got to love ourselves. We got to love ourselves more than we love them. And that means we got to come together. Because I can remember back in the day, I can say back in the early 90s, late 80s, we used to be tight. And I thought we was coming together, coming up. But the only thing they was doing was introducing drugs to our community and pulling us apart. And that's what they did. That's what happened. But now we got to take our streets back. We got to take our communities back. And we got to take back what's ours. We got to take back our kids for generations to come.
Right,
and
right.
You're setting an example, so I thank you for that. And I look forward to all that you have in store. I need you to share how those that are following can get in contact with you.
Let's see. My first page is Facebook, Corey Palmer. Then my business pages, though, my earring page, Duty Earrings and Corey. My author page, the author Corey Palmer. Instagram is favorite_big_homie85. All my books on Amazon. Also, you can hit me on my email, corey.palmer85@yahoo.com. I ship out everywhere with my earrings and my books. So.
Wow. You do a lot. You do a lot. And you homeschool.
Yes.
And you're a single parent. Whew. Bless your heart. Bless your heart. We need more men like you. And Clem. Yes, yes. For all the men that's standing up and doing what they're supposed to be doing, I appreciate you. Shout out to Avery Dawson. That's my nephew. He's doing it too. I appreciate y'all. I appreciate y'all. Because y'all are breaking the generational curse. And I appreciate y'all. Ashley.
Yes.
What you got going on? What you got coming up for 2021? I want to talk about 2021 because we got some time. And I want people to come over and follow y'all. I want them to get to know y'all. I want them to know who y'all are. Because y'all know I'm going to be right here on Sedora Radio every Sunday now. I forgot I got to make that announcement today. So everybody know now. We're making it loud and live right here with Ashley and Corey. Everybody know. Every Sunday, y'all can look forward to hearing me from 8 to 10 right here on Sedora Radio. So, what you got going on, Ashley?
Well, in 2021, I'm going to put out Hood Chronicles, and then I'm doing that poetry book with you with the two poems I got in there. First one called Her Words, and the second poem called Tough Girl. So after that, I'm going to put out another book called Sexual Appetite.
Ooh, wee. All right now. All right now. She's putting out. Ooh, wee.
All right.
I ain't going to touch on that one. Because you know I got what kind of show this is. We're not touching on that. I'm going to let the Holy Ghost get that one. Corey.
Yeah.
I can't do nothing but laugh. But you know what? That's life. All you can do is pray and go on. I love you, Ashley. Oh, we live. So y'all ain't no filters, ain't no hide nothing, ain't no nothing. This is real. This is live on air. I am authentic. I'm country. I'm from Levelland, South Carolina. A lot of people ain't never heard of that. But God is amazing. He is truly amazing. It's an honor and a privilege to be able to come on here and share with you guys and allow you guys to share your stories and your journeys to touch lives. I want y'all to share before we leave, because we got about 15 minutes. I want you guys to share exactly what you got going on for 2021, Corey. And then I want each one of you guys to share something inspirational that can encourage somebody listening throughout their week. because y'all know we still got all this craziness going on in the world, and we got to deal with this, and we got to be in this world, but we don't have to be of this world. So I want to keep people encouraged. So, Corey, we're going to start with you.
Well, 2021 is basically more books will drop. I'm trying to figure if I'm going to get this building or not to pursue my jewelry and everything. I got more things I want to add to the jewelry business, though, like purses, though, handbags, all type of stuff. Though, I'm trying to think about getting a brick and mortar building, though, and pursue that. You know what I'm saying? Have my own boutique, but basically be a single, you know what I'm saying, straight man with a boutique, though. You know what? Who will be the first one to do it, though, in my city, though? But that's what I'm thinking about doing most definitely, trying to get a boutique, though. You know what I'm saying? Here in the city, though, probably by mid-summer, if it's blessed with God, want me to do it. But, you know, like I told you, I got the earrings and everything going on. I'm about to add more watches to my collection. I got a model show today at 1 o'clock. You know, so I'm going to sit there and talk to her and see what, learn from this model show. If it's really what I want to do, though. You know, today could be that a day where if I'm really going to do this boutique, I'm going to figure out what I'm going to do once I go to the model show today.
Wow. I'm proud of you. I've seen your growth since we connected. We've been connected for a while. But I think this year has been the first year that we've really been actively interacting, you know, and I've seen your growth. So we may not connect every day, but I'm watching and I see you and I'm praying for you. I'm proud of you. Know that if nobody else tell you that. I'm proud of you, bro. Know that. So, Ashley, we got Chronicles. We got, I ain't going to say the other name of that book, but we got two books coming out. Y'all, this Ashley is one of the young people that I'm trying to mentor. And I'm trying. We're going to get there. But I'm proud of her growth. You know, sometimes, you know, I truly believe in the word. And sometimes the word say you have to draw by love. So I truly believe in showing love. And that's what I hope I've been showing across my platform, because that will cover a multitude of sin. And I love Ashley. She has great potential. And I look forward to working with her in 2021. I want you guys, before we leave, all that's going on, COVID-19 is on the rise. Social injustice ain't getting no better. All this with the president and everything that's going on. I want y'all to leave my listeners with something encouraging that can encourage them through this week. If they get sad, they get depressed, they may can go back and rewind this, because I'm going to upload this. For those that are tuned in on Facebook, know that y'all can get this on my YouTube. And those on Sador Radio, know that you can follow me on YouTube, Aspiring Authors Magazine, and you can hear this. I want y'all to leave them with something inspirational. We're going to start with Ashley.
Well, I want to say I want people to keep the faith. I know sometimes that with everything going on, you know, and we all have trials and tribulations that we face and go through. But you have to keep the faith. You know what I'm saying? Like Joe. Joe had never ever doubt God. You know, with all what's going on with him, he always had stick with God. So we got to learn how to keep the faith and never doubt and just keep going on and learn how to stick together. Instead of being so jealous and envy of one another, that's what we need to learn how to do. Keep the faith and stick together.
Amen, amen. Corey?
Well, my thing is to tell everybody with this right here, you know, I wrote the affirmation book, 52 weeks of affirmation for this reason right here. It's basically to inspire people, though. Like, you know, my affirmation book is a true thing about mental health. It's about power. It's about positive vibes, positive mindset, going into the year every day thinking positive, though. And that's what, you know, the main thing is thinking positive, though, with a fourth coming picture, though. You know what? No matter how bad the situation is, remember sunshine and rainstorms. That mean what I said for the sunshine and rainstorms. Whichever way it goes in life, you're going to have both of them. Some of them in the same day. But, you know, with sunshine and rainstorms, you got to remember, it's going to pour everywhere, pour down rainy one day. Sun goes shine. Go pour that rain next day. Sun goes shine. Which one you want to take over, the sunshine or the rainstorm, though? Like I said, they can both be in the same days, though. Sunshine and rainstorms, though. Which one is your ultimate purpose? The rainstorm? It's going to be the storm that you deal with. You can't get yourself out of the sunshine. Then, hey, it's a beautiful day. I'm going to take it for granted what it is, though. So when I say that to people, sunshine and rainstorm, think about which life you try to be in. Now, every day going to be perfect. I don't care what life you in, what money, situation, where you at in life. It don't matter. Ain't every day good. But is your good days better than your bad days? Your sunshine better than your rainstorm, though? Just think about that, though, y'all.
Amen. Amen. I tell you, that is powerful. That is powerful,
right?
Because
right.
I truly believe that everybody has a purpose in this world. And, you know, I want people to understand that he's given us these scriptures. He's given us the word. He's given us instruction to how we can live. And he's given us things that can help us through those times. You know, right now I'm standing on Luke 1 and 37 because he say faith. It does not make things easy, but it makes it possible. No matter what it looks like in the natural, we have to know that it's possible because he told us that. And his word is not going to return to him, Lord. And I want people to know that I don't care no matter where they are in life. I don't care. Ain't no sin bigger than the next sin. All sin is sin. And we have to understand that. And we all stand before the same God. We got to put religion out of the way. We got to put all these different, everything. We got to sit out aside and we got to search deep in our soul. That's what we got to connect. That's what we got to make the connection. And we got to make sure that's right. Because that's what live forever. That's what's going to determine if we're going to have eternal life or we're going to be set for doom. I want eternal life because I don't want to be here and suffering here in earth, in hell, and all this that we go through, and then have to live in hell for the rest of my life. I don't want that. So I definitely want to be set free. I want to be free, and I want to be able to have choices, and I want to live upright so that I know I can see my Father. But it ain't easy. But they know it's so much out there now. But we just got to make sure that we connecting with the Creator and have that relationship, because everybody believe that their religion is right. But who knows? We have one Creator, right? And he allowed all this. You see what I'm saying? So who's right? But all I know is you got to have a faith and you got to have a belief. And it all has to center back to that one person. But I say that to say this. I want y'all to be encouraged. I want y'all to know that you have purpose. Don't think that God just dropped you out the sky. No, he strategically placed you. He ordained you from your mother's womb. He called you. He named every hair on your head. Even though you ain't got none, Corey, you had some. And every last one of them had a name. He named us and he set us apart. He set us apart just for this time. I know y'all have wondered why I had to endure this. Why me? Because you were set apart. You were called in your mother's womb, and know that. No, it was not a mistake. And it wasn't a mistake that we all was on this airwave today, that we was on this live, that those that are tuning in, it was ordained. There's no mistake. It's in spite of what we see. He said everything worked together for his good, for our good. My bad, our good in his glory. He shall get the glory in all things, even in the bad things. But what's bad? Man has told us what's bad. Because it looks bad doesn't mean that it's bad. It'll make you think. It'll make you think. It'll make you think. But I want to thank you guys for coming on this morning, sacrificing. Ashley Known dropped off, but I want to thank you, Core,
no problem,
for coming
no problem
on this morning and sacrificing. She's back. And sharing, because it ain't always easy sharing your journey and sharing your testimony, because sometimes we want what people think. We oftentimes wonder what people think, but we got to put that away and stop worrying about what people think and put ourselves in a position where we can be a blessing from all those things that we've been through, even the things that we don't understand. We didn't go through it for nothing. And he'll reveal in due time why you went through it.
Yeah.
But you just keep enduring. You keep pressing. And don't think your labor is in vain. Somebody's watching. And somebody is receiving. Know that. You know, I thank God for you guys. I thank him for your journey. I thank him for allowing us to cross paths for whatever direction we go from here. I pray that God bless you guys on your journey. I don't take anything lightly. And the fact that he allowed you guys to cross my path, I bless you. I bless you on the day. I bless you on the day. I bless you on the day. In the name of Jesus. I thank him for y'all. Is there anything that y'all want to say before we go? Because I'm going to end this hour. I have to prepare for my second hour. I just love being able to open up my platform and allow individuals to come on and share, because I want people healed. I want people set free, and I want people to know who they are.
Right.
And I want them to be able to love themselves.
Right.
Because we've been through a lot in this world. You know, I just think about, you know, I just think about people these 400 years, and they brush it under the rug. And they say we're supposed to be okay with it. And, you know, we forgive, we turn out, we do all kind of stuff. But then they still coming at us. This election has really taught me a lot. You know, it's showed me a lot of people for who they are. You know, a lot of people have been hiding behind masks. And they've been hiding in these last couple of centuries, I'm going to say. Because when you think you're making progression, it seems like you're regressing. Because it seemed like when we got Obama, we was headed in the right direction. At least we thought we was headed in the right direction. And it just seemed like we just went back 50 years.
Right.
Because stuff that's happening now, I never thought I would see happen again. Because this is some stuff that you read about in books. And then some of the stuff they don't hear it from us. But then, it is what it is. I love you guys. And I thank you guys for coming on. Know that if there's anything that I can do, y'all always can reach out to AALAC or Aspiring Authors Magazine. Y'all know how to reach out to me. So please do so. I want to thank you guys for coming on today. I love you guys. And be blessed.
Yeah, girl.
You too.
Thank you. So I want to thank